How do I think that religious history relates to political and cultural history? And what do I think of the idea that religious history is kind of epiphenomenal? It's kind of something on the surface of other things that are much more real, like political and cultural history. I think in a way this is a version of an older question which used to come up certainly when I was very young, namely the Marxist idea that there is a superstructure and a substructure, and the substructure is where all the causality is, and the superstructure is froth on the top. And I mean, that particular idea, I think, when we no longer really believe. There the substructure was economic. Now the question is it political or cultural? And I think there just is a priori no particular reason why, when new things happen, they should be powered in one of those domains rather than another. I mean, something could perfectly start in cultural terms, it could start in political terms, it could start in religious terms. And I don't think anyone can make a really convincing argument that one of these is where it really happens and another is just epiphenomenal. And the question how I navigate between religious, political, cultural history, I mean, basically, you know, I'm comfortable with all of them. I think they all have a good reason to be there and to be done. I think where you have to be really careful is in asking your questions. I mean, if you just, I don't have a good example in mind, but you take a phenomenon, there isn't, so to speak, one big question to ask about any given phenomenon. There will be particular questions. One might be cultural, one might be political, one might be religious. Typically in this world that we inhabit, those things get kind of mixed up, and your questions will have to be very carefully phrased so that you identify just what it is you want in answer to that question. That's basically my approach to that.